Hello everyone, welcome to the 8th topic in this interference unit. Actually, in this there are two topics are there. One topic named called as oblique incidence of plane wave on a thin film due to reflected light system. This is also called as cosine law in reflected light system. Consider ABCD of thin film of thickness T and refractive index mu, and this is enclosed by an air medium. Now consider lambda wavelength of plane wave of light which is incidenting obliquely from P on the upper surface of the film AB at point Q. Now draw normal on the surface at that point, hence the light ray making an angle I with the normal. Now at point Q, some part of PQ light ray reflected along QR, and this light ray is making same angle with I. Hence, angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection, assuming this light ray QR is 1. Again, if you look at that point Q, then some part of PQ light ray refracted into this film and incident on lower surface of the film at S. Now draw a normal at point S. Then it touches the upper surface of the film at N. And QS light ray is making an angle R with the normal at point Q. Similarly, at point S also, the light ray QS is making an angle R with the normal. Assume this light ray QS is 2. Moreover, on the surface of a CD at S, the light ray QS part of light ray is refracted to out of the film as shown in this animation. This light ray is also making an angle I with the normal at S. Remaining part of light ray reflected and incidence on the upper surface of the film AB at T. This light ray ST is also making an angle R with the normal as shown in this animation. Assume this ST light ray is also 2. Again, at point T, part of light ray is reflected and some part of light ray is refracted. So, at point T, part of light ray is reflected and it is making an angle R with the normal. This is shown in this animation. Hence, inside the film, the angle of light rays with the normal is always R. At point T, some part of light ray is refracted out and reaches the point U. Hence, the light ray TU is making an angle I with the normal. Assume this light ray is also 2. Now, draw a line from point T on QR light ray 1 and it reaches perpendicularly to a point M. So, at point T on the surface AB and TM line, both are making an angle I. So, according to geometry, we can write as angle QTM is equal to I. This can be observed in this animation. Angle QSN is equal to R. This can be observed in this animation. And also angle TSN is equal to R. This can be observed in this animation. Hence, there exists a path difference in between the light rays 1 and 2. Path difference delta is equal to light ray 2 traveled in medium minus light ray 1 traveled in air. Why this equation has come? I will explain very clearly on here. At point Q, the refracted light ray 2 undergoes reflections and refraction. So the light ray too travel in QS, ST and TM. At point Q, the reflected light ray 1 reaches the point R. Hence, with respect to light ray 1, the light ray 2 traveled an additional path QS and ST, and with respect to light ray 2, the light ray 1 traveled an additional path QM. So from this analogy, we can write as path difference between two light rays 1 and 2 as delta is equal to QS plus ST, the distance traveled in medium, minus QM, the distance traveled in air. In the above statement, the first term, that is the QS plus ST, the light ray traveled the distance in medium. Since it is traveled in medium, hence the above equation can be written as delta is equal to mu into QS plus ST minus QM implies delta is equal to 2 mu QS minus QM since QS is equal to ST. Here QS and ST are equal distance. This is shown in this animation. So from triangle QTM we can write sin I is equal to QM by QT implies you can write the equation QM is equal to QT sin I. Hence the side equation can be written as QM is equal to 2QN sin I. Assume this is equation 1. Since the above equation can be written from QN is equal to NT. This is shown in this animation. But according to Snell's law, mu is equal to sin I by sin R. This equation can be written as sin I is equal to mu sin R. So put the sin I value in first equation. Therefore, QM is equal to 2 mu QN sin R. Assume this is second equation. So, but from the triangle QSN, we can write cos R is equal to NS by QS. So it can be written as QS is equal to NS by cos R implies QS is equal to T by cos R. Here, NS means thickness of the film, which is T. Assume this is third equation. Also, from this same triangle QSN, we can write as tan R is equal to QN by NS implies QN is equal to NS tan R. Therefore, the equation can be written as QN is equal to T into tan R. Assume this is the fourth equation. So, substitute 2, 3 and 4 in path difference equation. So, the path difference equation is delta is equal to 2 mu QS minus QM. Substitute these 2, 3 and 4 in this equation. So, we can write as delta is equal to 2 mu into T by cos R minus 2 mu into sin R into T into tan R is equal to 2 mu T by cos R 1 minus sin square R. Simplify the above equation, then we get delta is equal to 2 mu T by cos R into cos square R. Here, 1 cos R term will get cancelled. So, the path difference becomes delta is equal to 2 mu T cos R. Assume this is fifth equation. So, this equation is called the cosine law. Moreover, this equation meant for reflected light system. Hence, the condition for brightness for 1 and 2 light rays is delta is equal to 2 mu T cos R is equal to 2n plus 1 into lambda by 2 Here, n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, so on. We can take any value from this. Assume this is 6th equation. So the condition for darkness for 1 and 2 light rays is delta is equal to 2 mu t cos r is equal to n lambda. Here n is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. We can take any value from these values. Assume this is 7th equation. So this is a complete description for the reflected light system in a thin film of obliquid incidence. So this is our topic. So please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.